Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're taking a look at an application that is available through SetApp called BeFocused Pro. Now this is an application that is a Pomodoro timer, so we're going to be just overviewing a few of the features, giving an idea what it does. Pomodoro timers are a really effective way to be able to manage sort of stints of time in terms of being able to set a timer and get started with the task. It's becoming very popular in offices as a way to organize and allow yourself to keep focused. So it basically lives up here. It's available for Mac. I believe they have an iPhone edition. I'll include any other relevant information in the description below. But for example, if I wanted to start a 25-minute timer, I could easily do that. Now, the great thing is, obviously, you can go off the traditional 25 minutes timers, but you can go to settings and you'll be able to find that in the cog. You can actually change the length of time over here, the work interval, to anything from 15 minutes to 5 minutes to a longer stint of 55 minutes if that's something you want to work on. So let's say I want to work on 20-minute stints with a 4-minute break just to be a little bit shorter. Obviously, that's going to work out. And you can also change the longer break durations. So that's every time you have 4 major cycles, it will open up a longer break, which is aimed there. You've also got target intervals for the day. So for example, if I set that at 5, we could have that rolling. You've also got a few more settings, which I'll come back to near the end of this video. So it's really simple. All you have to do is set a new task. You can press add task to be able to get that started. If I went and said film BeFocused Pro video, then I can press the play button and naturally the timer begins. Okay, so it's really, really simple. As you can see, the timer has gone dramatically down here. During any session, just to be clear, you can pause it and play it, which really helps when it comes to, you know, I don't know, some interruptions that might not necessarily be triggered by yourself, like an employee asking you a question, or even someone next to you just tapping you on the shoulder, just curious about something very, very short. So you might want to just pause it. Now, the good thing is you can exit in any time if you do get a major interruption, which will essentially skip the work interval. I do believe if you skip the work interval, it won't actually be logged as a task, which is a bit of a shame. But then again, that's the whole methodology of the Pomodoro timer. So here we go. We're just about to finish a cycle. As you can see, a timer pops on and you can start your 4-minute break. That's the one we set up here. So you can see down here that today at 1, so we've got 1 out of 5 tasks completed. You can go to this sort of tab and see that I've completed 1 cycle of this task. And what's quite handy is you will still be on that task when you're done. And you can actually choose how many Pomodoro timers you're going to be dedicating to it. So for example, there was this task that I set up called New Task. And I dedicated 7 Pomodoro timers to it. And you can naturally hit play when you want to get started. And you can sync up here. And sync is a specific login feature, so you need to sign up and log in for that one. But if I wanted to add a new task, then I could. So for example, if there's something in the afternoon like edit code a video that I have to do, then I can play the timer right here. So that's really easy and pretty non-disruptive. Now, if I go back here, I can obviously skip the break if I want to. So I can carry on with the task. Or what I can do is I can go and find the edit code video here and start beginning that task. So that's how you switch between tasks. Once I complete this one here with the 0, one will be added, which means 1 full cycle has been dedicated to that. And then once everything's finished, you can give it a nice tick off. So I've filmed this video and I could say new task is done as well. Then I could go to done and I can see a little bit of a list of exactly what I've done. Now, again, this doesn't link up with any of the applications that are out there already. There are other applications I'm looking to do what can Pomodoro timers connect with Todoist, but this is a very simple one. It's available through, as I mentioned, the SetApp subscription. which is an app that I recommend. It's actually really easy to use, but you can find specific productivity apps in this section, and there's a whole host of them here. So I do recommend checking it out. It's part of the MacPaw company, and they also do Clean My Mac, which is another tool that I use. It's not a sponsorship, but I just find their tools pretty decent. And as you can see, it works fairly simply, I guess, for Mac users. Now, one of the final things I totally missed out is you can tick off a task up here. And as you can imagine, that task has been completed. So guys, a big thank you. Hopefully you found this video useful. Let me know in the comments below which apps you've used and whether this one was useful for you. Anyway, guys, make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers, everyone.